Welcome to the next session of ANSYS APDL. In this session, we are going to solve for a simply supported beam which is subjected to uniformly distributed load, that is UDL. We will start with preferences, structural, OK, preprocessor, element type, add, edit, delete, add, beam, two node, OK. Close this option. Then I'll go to material properties, material model, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic. I'll choose the value as 2E5 because it is structural steel and the Poisson's ratio is 0.3. Next I'll go to section beam, common section. I'll choose the breadth as 30 and the height as 30. Okay. Sections is done. Next, I'll go to modeling, create key points in active CS. First node is at 000. The second node is say at 200 mm from the start. Let's take up a third node, which is at 400 mm from the start. Then I have the fourth node, which is at 600 mm from the start. Okay, so you can see I have created four key points this time. I'll go to line, straight line. I'll choose the four points and form a beam. This is done. Next, I'll go to meshing, size control, manual size, global size. Say the number of divisions are 6. Okay, then I'll go to mesh, lines, pick all. So the meshing is done. Now if I go to numbering and I see the element number, I can see there are many elements that are formed over here. So if I don't want to use them, it's okay. But if I want to use it, that's also fine. Next, I'll go to loads, define load, apply. Structural displacement on key point. So on the first key point, say I want to apply fixed, okay. On the other side, say I apply a roller for which UY will be 0, okay. Then I'll want to apply say a force. If you want, you can apply a point load also in this question. So let me apply a point load on the key point over here. So I can apply the key point, okay, and let me apply a force in y direction as say minus 100, okay. Then I want to apply some pressure, that is my UDL. So I'll go to on beam and I will choose the portion on which I want to apply the UDL. So let me choose certain portion. Okay. Now load key has to be changed to 2 because I want to apply in the y direction. 1 stands for x, 2 stands for y. So I want to apply along the y axis. So I'll write here 2. Now since the pressure value is same at I and J node, it is written here leave blank for uniform pressure. So I will be just applying the value as say 20. Okay. So here is my UDL applied over the selected portion of the beam. So this completes my UDL application. Next I'll go to solution, solve, current LS, okay. Solution is done. So I'll close everything and I'll go to general post processing, plot results. Deformed shape is what I want to see first. So I'll choose deformed plus undeformed. Okay, so here I can see the deformation of the beam. Next, suppose I want to see the contour plot. So I'll go to nodal solution, degree of freedom, displacement vector sum. If I want to see both deformed and undeformed model, okay. So this is how I can see it. I can also go to stress and see the von Mises stress. So these are the results that I obtain. If you want, you can also list the values and you can check the results. That is by going to nodal solution in listed results, degree of freedom, displacement vector sum. So here I can get the listed values on the various nodes. This is how the numerical is supposed to be solved for a simply supported beam subjected to uniformly distributed load. I hope you have understood the procedure. If you have any doubts, please write to me in the comment section. See you in the next session. Thank you.